looking at it on an individual basis, you have a very interesting story to tell after this election and then the reform agenda, and then somehow you find yourself arrested in a sense.
The torture, the militarization of all aspects of politics in Uganda never stopped in an election. I remember shortly after elections when my leader left South Africa, I was with my colleague Mugumya Sam distributing Christmas cards, and we distributed a number of them, so many, I think about 2,000 Christmas cards within Kampala. Then we went to distribute the ones for army generals. Those they have only one headquarter in Bombo, so we decided to go to Bombo. When we went to Bombo,
you must be a very brave man. You are distributing opposition cards to army generals in Uganda.
I thought the army is supposed to be neutral, serving Uganda, and not any government.
So you go to Bombo.
I go to Bombo, and we delivered our cards. But the army commander, on looking at the cards as we were getting out, he ordered his soldiers to pick us again. So soldiers came and picked us, and we were really arrested badly and tortured and kept at the quarter guard for the whole Christmas. And we were saved by some soldiers who were in prison, who actually had to call our leaders. So then it was now broadcasted on CBS, and everybody knew that we had been detained. So that is how we were saved. Otherwise, soldiers were telling us, if we are not where they are keeping you, they kill people who they are going to kill.